Welcome to the quickest quiz on radio. Good sound effect today.
Thank you very much. You like that?
Today's contestants are Chris Evans and Anna de Armas.
Oh, that's very exciting. You feeling nervous yet? A little bit?
No, I'm cool.
Oh, okay. Fine. Here are the rules then, all right? We're going to ask you 5 questions. You have 5 seconds to answer the first question, but we then deduct a second of time with each question, leaving you just 1 second to answer the final question. Get all 5 right, you become our reigning champions.
Okay, Chris, you're up first, mate.
Okay.
Here we go.
Question 1.
Name a famous British person with the name Chris.
5 seconds to answer.
Well, there is a Chris Evans, but there's a, I'll say Chris Martin as well.
Oh, yeah. All right, 2 in
extra then. Points.
Just show it off. 2 in. I will do this.
This is too much for me. I have to go.
Correct. Well, I'm very shocked because the one, there's obviously so many options you could have gone for. I've literally got here Chris Evans written down.
Radio
legend right there.
Radio legend.
Just below us, right?
Confused with him, yeah. There's another Chris Evans. There's no other Anna de Armas.
There's
there?
Not.
I don't know.
Anna, you're going to be fine. Here we go.
No.
Anna, this is your one.
Question 2.
All right. Which of the following movies has Chris Evans not starred in? Buzz Lightyear, The Avengers, or The Notebook?
4 seconds to answer.
The Notebook.
All right, loads of time.
You give me the easy one.
Yeah. Look at all this extra good. Time.
Much to my chagrin, yeah.
It was good.
We said
you
notebook.
Said The Notebook.
Correct.
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 Another point in the bag. It's going well. It's going well. Let's see what happens here.
Question 3.
Chris.
Yeah.
Anna starred in James Bond alongside Daniel Craig. But what was the name of this 007 movie?
3 seconds no time to that. Answer.
Oh, whoa. My God!
Straight in.
Straight
in. Come on, y'all saw, right?
Easy.
Real
we
good.
We might have our first celeb champions. Wow, I'm very excited about this.
That would be very cool.
I have a feeling that this one is bad.
Remember.
2 seconds.
Here we go. 2 seconds to answer.
Question 4.
Anna, back to you.
This is bad.
What is the maximum length of a TikTok video?
2 seconds to answer.
15 seconds. No, that's okay. Bad.
Game master, everything that's bad.
That's bad.
That's very bad.
Okay. Well,
I don't have TikTok. I don't even know what it looks like.
It's fine. You said 15 seconds.
No.
We could say
it's wrong.
It is wrong.
50,
you know, it's now 3 minutes.
3 minutes.
Oh, no, it's too long.
It's too long.
It's too long.
Apparently, they're making it 10 minutes next month.
Wow.
A 10-minute TikTok video. It's too much.
Well, wow. we'll get the Grey Man, the full movie, on TikTok.
This is, yeah.
Oh, man.
Don't worry.
That's
don't
right.
worry.
We failed already.
I'm glad I didn't get that.
Okay, Chris, this is the last question. Okay. If you get this right, we're going to have a combined score of 4 out of 5. So you will go
which
top.
Which ain't bad.
That's top of the celeb leaderboard.
Okay.
All right? Here we go. Let's see what we land on.
Question 5.
What is the Queen of England's first name?
1 second to
Elizabeth.
Answer.
Right? You can't get that wrong here.
No, oh, God.
You don't want to get it wrong here. You get it wrong in England, everyone starts throwing tea and crumpets at you.
Right.
Everyone goes mad.
That's right.
You answered Elizabeth.
I think it's Elizabeth, yeah.
Come on, that's it.
Correct! Well done.
Very nice.
4 out of 5, top of the leaderboard. Thank you guys so much.
I feel bad. I'm so guilty.
Hey, don't feel bad.
It was good. And you don't have TikTok, so we can let you off.
It's not your fault.
It's fine.
I love the fact that Chris so casually went, oh, I don't feel bad. I mean, it wasn't me who got it wrong.
I'm very glad I didn't get asked that question because I had no idea.
The Grey Man, out in cinemas and on Netflix right now. Guys, you must have had so much fun just filming it in general. It must have been wicked, right?
We did.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, a lot of people working with familiar faces and a lot of people that, you know, you have a level of comfort with. So yeah, it was a really good time.
Yeah, because the directors are the Russo brothers, right? And you've worked with the Russo brothers so much. I mean, we are big Marvel fans.
Oh, great.
So this was very exciting for us. Also, can I quickly say, I'm very sad that you haven't just got the Tash going on now. And I'm sure so many people are saying this to you.
You know, it was a look. It was a look.
It was.
And it really worked for the role, but you know, shaving it was liberating.
Yeah.
Was you a big fan of the Tash? Did you like it?
I did love it.
You did. And obviously, Anna, we saw you recently in the latest Bond movie, right?
Yeah.
So we know you've taken to action films like no one's business, absolutely smashing it. But this film seems to be like a jump up in terms of action and everything going on for you. So was this hard?
Sure.
Was it hard to prepare for?
Extremely hard. I didn't know what I was getting myself into. I mean, Bond was amazing. I loved that experience. But for real, I did not have time to prepare. Mm. So I just pulled it off, like, on the spot, like, learned the choreographies and did it. But for this one, we had, like, almost 3 months of prep. And I had to learn, like, shooting and handling every weapon that I use in the movie and getting used to the weight and moving with all these things on me and the stunt training and choreographies and all of that. It's a lot. It's a lot. I didn't know if I was going to make it. Yeah, I definitely pushed my limits. My discipline, my commitment, my pain tolerance, everything. But then you see the movie and the result is just so awesome. And scenes that are so big and you're just shooting your part. You don't see what's going on the other side with Ryan, what's going on with Chris. Mm-hmm. And then when you see it all together, you know, it's very gratifying.
I want to know, how was it working with Ryan on this movie? Because we've seen a lot of him recently. The Grey Man is very different to Ken that we're seeing over going on right now. Like, sure. The contrast there. So what was that like?
He's good. I mean, he's very committed. You know, if you don't block that punch, it might hit you. Mm-hmm. Actually, I posted something on Instagram once. You know, when you punch somebody and you do a fake punch, but when you punch someone, you do a boxer block. You know, you kind of cover your ear and that gives you a lot of surface area to land a fake punch. Ryan, on occasion, just being amped up and excited for the scene, would meet the block, meaning he'd put his arm out to block you. So when you punch, he'd block you with his forearm. And if anyone has ever done this before, you can only do this so many times. You know, you hit the forearm, you say, goddamn, you know.
Just a dead arm.
It's brutal. I mean, I posted this picture online, but by the end of the day, my forearm was destroyed. But again, it's because Ryan is, you know, really amped up and he takes it really seriously. He doesn't take a take off. Mm-hmm. To him, there is no phoning it in, you know. He's fighting for real. So
be ready. If you
don't block it, you're gonna get knocked out.
I do wanna say this, Chris. Ono, you're gonna have to help us out as well. Me and Perry, we've been best friends our entire lives, right? Mm-hmm. Growing up with each other. We've only ever had one argument. Okay.
Uh-oh.
Chris, you're kind of to blame in a weird way.
No.
You are. You're actually heavily involved.
What was it?
So we said that we're big Marvel fans, right?
Okay.
We had a Captain America shield sent to this studio. Mm-hmm. They only sent one. And because they only sent one, that then started a big argument between me and Perry about who gets to take it home. And then it starts off as a joke, and then it starts to get a bit more serious. And I was like, I've got kids. I was like, I don't care about your kids. I don't care about my kids. And it's kept growing and growing and growing.
Oh, my God, guys, we got to get you another shield.
So, without telling you who got the shield or who won the argument, based on initial vibe, who do you think is the most Captain America-esque?
Yeah.
Who should?
As I fold my arms.
I love the way
Nah, this is impossible.
I'm going to start saying random quotes now.
This is impossible. I think the most Captain America response I can give is, we got to get another shield in here. There's no way I can say there's one or the other.
The most diplomatic
response is, we need another shield. If y'all are both fans, and we need another shield.
Would you like to know the answer?
You seem to chill.
Okay.
So you got the shield.
I got the shield. It was me.
He's still very unhappy.
All right, fine. At least I'll still get one.
Yeah, you get one in the end.
Every time I go to Jules' house, I look at his kids. I'm like, oh. Go away. I'm sick of it.